tonight as we're set to take on the fifth match of the evening.
Oh, and he rocked his bell. Actually, Azaev threw a jab, a nice straight jab to Al-Ghafri's face. And that jab, you know what you notice? Azaev has that reach with a jab, and he clocked him twice, three times now. And now he's gonna go to...
Isayev's got the back, and he can finish it right here. Big throw by Isayev as he looks for some kind of finish. Muhammad is doing the right thing by baseball back. It's like it's a baseball bat grab of the arm. He lets go of it now. Now Muhammad Isayev just needs to get his hooks in and control this fight. Yeah, Isayev really needs to get the hooks in to finish the fight.
He seems like he's getting a guillotine.
He's got to get, there it is right there. He could finish it.
No, he got out of it. He could finish it.
He's doing the right thing by baseballing bat, by doing a baseball grip against the hands there. Two hands on one is the right thing to do. It's a matter of strength now. The hooks that Isayev has implanted into Muhammad Al-Ghafri's legs are crucial to the win.
Al-Ghafri has a great heart of a lion, actually. Twice I thought he's going to tap out. And now he's getting a breather.
This is the right thing to do right now. He's just got to now fight off the strength of Isayev, which is what he's doing. He's isolated the left arm of Isayev, and he's trying to weed his left leg out of the hooks, which is the right thing to do.
He should hold on to that left arm and not let it go, because the minute I let it go, he's going to give him a sleeper and get him to sleep.
And he got out of it. Excellent, excellent defense by Muhammad Al-Ghafri. I mean, it was just perfect right there. He stayed calm and composed. Isayev has lost his hooks now.
That was a textbook on how to get out of... And he turned around.
Very, very nice. Very nice escape by Jafri.
I think the referee is warning him because he thought he's going to kick him to the head.
Yeah.
I didn't think there was anything wrong with it, but the referee was no better.
Again, in the heat of battle, things happen. Just let him fight.
You know, there's 30 seconds left on the clock. A little bit less than 30 seconds.
This could be going to the second round, Rio.
Let's hope so. You know, I love for the fans to get what they paid for. They came in to see a great match, three-round match. And we're going to the second round.
Isayev's doing the right thing with throwing the jabs, keeping distance between them, and it's going to the second round. That was excellent display of defense by Al-Ghafri, keeping very calm and collected, isolating that left arm. I honestly believe the isolation of that left arm is the reason he got out of that choke. Absolutely. He took his time out of that.
You know, maybe he lost the round, but he displayed a great technical knowledge on how to get out of the guillotine. He actually gave you the heart, the technique, and I think that goes a long way because that might actually shift the momentum.
Here it is right here. He actually, Isayev has sunk in a very deep guillotine. Muhammad Al-Ghafri, two hands on Isayev's one hand, baseball bat grip, pulls it out, and then isolates the arm. Excellent display of jiu-jitsu defense right there.
I agree.
There is Contender MMA's wrestling coach, Contender's very own,
three scheduled rounds.
As he set the corner, Muhammad Isayev.
So 3 minutes per round. Wolverine fighting out of the blue corner.
You know, it looks like Muhammad Isayev is a bit winded. He's breathing hard, and he's exerted a lot of energy.
It's round two.
Well, experience goes to Al-Ghafri. He's been in this situation before. This is Isayev's first fight, but he's doing all the right things. Actually, both fighters are doing all the right things. Nice inside leg kick by Al-Ghafri. spinning back fist by Asayev.
But missed by Miley. You should always drop it higher than you think it is, and it's going to land to the head. You know, the good thing about Al Ghafri, he's making it a striking contest. He doesn't want to go to the floor where they actually, it might be to the advantage of Muhammad Asayev. And there are some wild shots from both fighters. Bunch of haymakers. It should be a little bit more precise. You know, actually, Muhammad Asayev has a great weapon with his straight jab, and he's not using it, and he goes to the floor.
Al Ghafri just smiles at him as Asayev throws really crazy haymakers. Asayev's looking for some kind of dominant position right now. It looks like he's setting up. Oh, yeah, I thought he was setting up some kind of ankle lock there, Rio.
Textbook. Al Ghafri's doing textbook. Very nice. Low kicks. He's forcing Muhammad Asayev to go back.
Muhammad Asayev lets him stand up. Oh, big left. Misses the face of Al Ghafri. And Al Ghafri's looking for another haymaker knockout.
Asayev should concentrate on the jabs, but he's not doing it. But regardless, there are some wild shots. There should be more precision on these fights.
Oh, uppercut. Both fighters are looking tired. Both fighters have their hands down. It's going to be a slugfest.
Well, with one more minute to go, maybe it'll go and survive to the third round unless somebody lands. And you know, all you need is a lucky shot, and it seems that Asayev just landed two of them.
Asayev gets the back again. He's looking for some kind of trip, takes it to the ground. Full mount by Asayev. And he could finish it here if he gets... He's trying to isolate the right arm and set up an arm bar, Rio. Look, he's positioning himself right now. He's trying to set up an arm bar. Takes the back.
Again, he goes. I don't think Al Ghafri would be so lucky if Asayev would do the exact same thing.
If Al Ghafri gets out of this one, I am going to eat this microphone. Again, Al Ghafri isolates the left hand of Asayev, which prevents it from putting pressure on the guillotine choke. There it is again. What? Baseball bat grip.
It seems that he got his
Sorry.
It seems that he got his number. And actually, he survived a second.
I guess.
It's twice that actually Asayev tries that sleeper, and twice Al Ghafri gets out. You know, eventually it becomes like card game, and you go to a push. Al Ghafri is now winning, but he's losing on points. He's beating points. Yes, he's doing a technical fight, but if you look at it, Asayev is the dominating fighter in the two rounds.
As I was saying earlier, there is Alain, the wrestling coach of Contender MMA, in the corner of Asayev.
Night two. Take a short break after, but 3 minutes to decide this one. Will it be red? Will it be blue? Let's find out. Let's go to the cage.
I think Muhammad's tired, Rio.
I think both Muhammads are tired, Ali. Yeah, absolutely. Let's see, but I do believe that if Al Ghafri has to do something, he has to do it now. He has to start the round by trying to go for the knockout. A win for this round will not help him.
Yeah, I definitely think the judges' scorecards are calling Asayev to win. Twice he's had the attempt at the submission. That rear naked choke was very deep in the first round and in the second round as well. Now, Muhammad Al Ghafri did a great job of defending it both times. and he's looking for that haymaker knockout to end this fight.
Well, to save one
thing. Great kick by Muhammad Al-Jafri.
He survived two rounds. He needs the knockout.
Very nice kick. Again, throws another wild kick. Some nice kicks keeping Esaev at bay. Esaev throws the low kick of his own, returns the favor and takes it where he wants it.
There was a nice uppercut straight to Esaev's face that rocked him a little bit, that had him to push him to go back.
Nice. And Muhammad Esaev gets it exactly where it was. Nice side mount. Very dominant position for Esaev here. Here he can work a couple of things, Royo. I see he's automatically trying to set up the Americana, but he can go into a full mount as well and finish it with some ground and pound.
And he proved you wrong. He just went to full mount. You're right.
Very, very nice.
Very high
dominant position for Esaev. He could set the armbar here, which is what he's looking to do, or go for the back. He could slip the choke. He's trying to isolate the arm for an Americana.
And he gets it onto the
and
wrist.
And he locks it. Jafri defends by straightening out the arm. And they're really sweaty at this moment, you know. Things are very difficult to hold on to now.
Absolutely. You can have a great technique available and you get it, but it slips just by the sweat alone. I don't see Esaev striking, but I see him trying to choke him again. And there's 10 seconds to go. Two, one.
I think these guys get caught up in the fight, Rio. They don't know where to stop.
Well, I think the horn should be a little bit longer, because that's why we see it happen. They keep on fighting.
Muhammad Al-Jafri is fired up as we get ready to go into the third round. And he is getting the crowd pumped. Esaev, on the other hand, looks a bit gassed. It is his first fight, so he doesn't know what to expect. And he's doing a phenomenal job, but I think the experience is definitely in the hands of Al-Jafri. Well, or should I say Al-Gafri, because he got a bit upset at me yesterday that I said Al-Jafri. It's actually pronounced Al-Gafri.
Al-Gafri, I think.
Yeah.
Well, you can tell that Al-Gafri left some Wolverine marks on his body.
I knew you were going to come up with some corny joke.
No, I mean...
Eight more fights still to come. Daniel live from the Haptor Grand Beach Resort and Spa, home of live MMA in the UAE. UFC Fight Night 2, presented by Dubai Sports and FX Middle East, and powered by our sponsors here this evening. Icon Pro Labs, Medcare, Ringleader, and Contender MMA Training Center. All tonight's fights sanctioned by the Dubai Sports Council. The decision's in. The judges have reached a decision. Judge Bukash scores it 30-27. Judge Zaki scores it 29-27. Judge Amous scores it 30-27. So the winner, by unanimous decision, is...
Muhammad's winning.
From the red corner, Muhammad Esaev.
Well, you know, I thought that was a pretty fair call, Rio.
Yeah.
Muhammad, although inexperienced in the cage, Muhammad Esayev, although inexperienced in the cage, was a lot more active, a lot more dominant on various
debut fight
areas.
For you this evening. One fight,
well, according
one
to
win.
Zaki, one
what
of the
was
judges
the experience
from
like for
he
you?
Gave him 29-27, and that means there was one round. I think the first round was evenly matched. And then the last two rounds went to Esayev. So that's correct call.
And he asked the same for all his coach, and Allah helped me him to win here. Thank you for it.
And one final one as well. There's a lot of Russian supporters here. A quick word for all the Russian support in the room.
Huh?
A quick word for all the Russian fans, all the Russian support here.
Dagestan.
All the Russian spectators here supporting Muhammad.
Yes, all for him.